According to Proskovia Nebanja, the chief executive officer of Uganda National Oil Company, UNOC, in 2017, the storage facilities were rehabilitated and the government contracted one petroleum company to use them until today, when the government decided to take over full control.
The purpose of us being here today is to take over the operatorship of Jinja Storage Terminal. We have been in a partnership with One Petroleum as our partner over this terminal, and it has come to a time when One Petroleum has revisited their portfolio. They want to focus on their core business and therefore have handed over the facility back to us.
The fuel reserves have a storage capacity of 30 million liters of fuel. She adds that they intend to improve the operational efficiency of the reserves by constructing a pier at Ripon Falls in Jinja City.
The operational efficiency of this terminal, reason being that the daily consumption of Uganda is about 6.3 to 6.5 million liters a day, which means if you have a 30 million liter capacity terminal, you can only be covered as a country under 5 days. So it's critical for us to take over the operation of this terminal, improve the operational efficiency, and one of the ways of improving that operational efficiency is to open up for lake transport.
During the ceremony, the Jinja South Division Mayor Ashraf Nasser expressed his dissatisfaction with the state of Malabar Jinja Road.
The roads of starting from Busia to Jinja, and I think the way you came in, you were massaged properly while you were coming in because of the potholes. But luckily enough, because of the USMID project, we are doing that road going all the way to Clive Road. And thanks to the government of Uganda. But the lorries that have been dropping here, all the way from Kenya, coming into Jinja, they've been destroying our roads.
The Minister for Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabira, explains that the demand for fuel in the country has increased due to the increasing number of vehicles and the population.
Storage, even at home, whether it is storage of foodstuff or storage of whatever, it is very important. This facility was constructed in the 1970s, indeed to serve the people of Uganda, to be sure that government at that time had storage of fuel. Unfortunately, the population has grown on and on, and the demand, because of the number of vehicles that we have now, the demand has grown on. That we need, first of all, to manage this facility very well, but also to plan for more tanks to be constructed. Products that we are going to construct in PG Namwabula.
The Minister for Finance, Matia Kaseja, asked the board members of Uganda National Oil Company to work tirelessly and also publicize the company such that the entity makes profits.
Don't forget, you have to make money for me. I need that money, that income. So you must operate efficiently like a private business entity. Stop the civil service culture. Decision taking 10 days, 1 year. No, Mr. Katongole can tell you, in business, if you delay just by 1 hour, you can lose a deal of 100 million.
Taking back the Jinja Fuel Reserve facility will create more jobs. The government is also aiming at removing all heavy cargo vehicles off the roads, and cargo should be transported using the railway, as Minister Kaseja explains.
These trucks off the road, because they are spoiling the road. I was in Busia recently. That road is almost finished now because of those heavy trucks. We want to have now all heavy traffic, heavy cargo to come by rail, either the standard gauge railway or the meter gauge railway.
Compiled by Emmanuel Balokuse and Donald Kiria for the news.